play really carefully. He's going to have to work around a lot of big hitboxes. Yep. Bear in mind that Frog's not unfamiliar with the matchup. He did beat Ixis a couple of DBZs ago.
That is very true. That is very true. This is definitely scary for... It's got to be scary for Aperture right now.
Absolutely. And what you got to hope is that his head is not down after losing to Mitsu. You know he would have felt like he should have won that set. And so hopefully he's going to keep his head up. He's going to come into this strong. There you go, straight away. Looks like he's running in, but not the case. All right, Frog doing a good job with those nairs. And look at that, nair to pin, but doesn't carry on the string. Frog's doing a great job of just calling out Aperture's movement.
Nice little
57%. Oh, goodness, that could have been very, very painful for Aperture.
Trying to get falling fair to Dragon Pack shot. That is meant to be a true combo in certain percentages. I feel like he might have just off of that.
Oh, but Aperture transitioning really nicely from platform to stage there. And it kind of feels like he's starting to find his rhythm. Oh, but good pin from Frog, and that almost takes the stock.
106%, not quite there, but it's definitely going to be scaring Aperture just a little bit. Wow, look at that Frog just leaping forward with two empty hops, or empty pins.
And that does take the stock. That was not ideal.
That seems DI, that did seem to be a little bit too early.
Frog Aperture is just rolling around there.
Or Frog rather. Well, Frog rolling around to counter the spin dash, I suppose.
There we see he's just creating an aura around him with that sword of his. He's throwing out nairs, throwing out fares, and he's doing a great job of keeping Sonic out. Oh, Aperture going back to that tried and trusty Hypno Smash, but that is
then
sick.
Then down air.
Hey, you footstool down air.
Footstool down air even. I had the pleasure of getting hit by that earlier today.
Oh, and look at that, 43%. Aperture's right back in it. He went for it again.
Okay.
Not finding the sweet spot
calm
this
down,
time,
Luke.
But Aperture's woken up. Goodness me.
Just had to take a moment, try to feel out the game a bit, but now... Now that he's what kind of sussed out what, you know, Frog's all about, he's just having fun with the game, it looks like.
Alright, and after that burst of aggression, Aperture is perfectly happy
he
to go back
really
to just finding his space.
Spin dash down there.
That was nicely done. Frog really didn't need to jump into him there. He could have just jumped out of the situation or let it run out, you know. The pin does... After a while, just right, laps.
Rock does have an edge guard situation on his hand. See what he can do. Corrin, very,
very good.
There.
Nice. Nicely done. Oh, and finds a tip of pin.
After trying to punish the back air, just out of habit, and Frog just ready to, knowing that, you know, about the
And Frog just, oh, there's the back air of his own.
Answer it straight away.
And this is...
This is as close as it gets.
Absolutely. It kind of feels like they've just been throwing punches at each other and then retreating back to their corners for the next round. Goodness. And there we go. Frog finding Aperture pinned at the ledge. And this is a difficult situation. He's paid 55% to get back to the stage. But as we've seen, Aperture can turn it around in moments.
Still,
and this is good patience. You know, he's not pushing too hard.
Loving this movement from Aperture right now, though. Look at that.
Now, nicely done there. Aperture realizing that he didn't have a punish. Just taking a step back, letting Frog get back to his feet, and trying to avoid... Oh! Homing attack there, and paying off.
All right. 20%
now.
This is
good patience.
Oh,
goodness me. This is...
Wouldn't have killed, I don't think.
Not at 60%, no.
Oh, I don't know. If it was at the tipper, though. A little bit charging Timber then. I want to
Frog
say
now
that
is spacing so very nicely on those lances. He's just hitting the very tippy toes of Sonic.
Well, you have to.
Ooh, forward throw. Again, an offstage situation, but this time the Smashville platform coming in handy to get him back on stage.
I like that pressure from Dragon Crunchrock. Unfortunately, it didn't pay off.
Oh, good up air to call out the down air from Aperture there.
Just a single Ooh, dragon patch.
Just waited for him to overcommit and then rolled onto stage.
After doing a very good job, holding onto the stage.
Oh, goodness
if
me.
That went through.
He's found
it! Again. There it is. I told you he was looking for it.
Sonic dodge first! Sonic dodge first!
No. Oh, no.
Oh, wow.
He didn't get his double jump off.
Oh, goodness me. That's so unfortunate.
Ixis. Taking the stage to provide immediate comfort. Oh, that is tragic.
Goodness me.
Fellow Sonic mains comforting each other. Ixis, he knows the pain.
And that's so difficult, you know. Aperture, you know, had that moment of triumph where he's like, yes, I've hit it. I've taken this back. I've stolen it from him. But only to have it torn away. And I think I just saw a moment of heartbreak.
Just a single violin tone emanated from the stage.
Oh, goodness me, I am... That is so upsetting.
Aperture, it looks, definitely looks devastated right now.
Alright, so where do you take him? You know, what stage do you want to go back to? Like, Corrin does so well with platforms.
I feel like Aperture would ideally go, you know, Final Destination if he had the choice. I suspect that's probably getting bad. He is looking at Battlefield.
That could play out well because we saw some really early KOs from Frog with the tippers. And so if Aperture can live just another 5-10%, that could be a big difference in the outcome of the set.
At the same time, these platforms are very nice position for Corrin's up smash, I think, to, you know, just tip.
They are, and you can do a lot of pin
course,
shenanigans.
Yeah.
The platforms are high enough, set high enough, that if you pin on one of those and kick into the center of the stage, you have the ability to move again before you hit the ground, which means you can throw out something like a Dragon Fang shot or a back air to keep yourself safe.
Yeah.
Oh, but well weighted there from Aperture.
At the same time, it is a stage that gives, you know, Aperture a lot of space to kind of mess around. I know.
What I like here is that after, oh goodness me, big damage there, but not enough to take the stock just yet. After really seems to have come into this with his head held high, you know. Oh goodness, that was very close.
I know after, you know, if he's trying to take after Ixis, he'll be trying to take control of these platforms, just use them to attack his, you know, attack Frog from every angle.
And yeah, I was expecting that Frog would really enjoy having these platforms to work with, but Aperture
proving
me
wrong.
It's
not looking well for him.
Of course, we've seen so far that this set could go either way at any moment. You know, it's very intense from the get-go.
Frog, as you said, definitely knows this matchup very well. Keeping it close against the top Sonics in the UK.
Yeah, absolutely. And oh, that was almost the back air to take the stock. Aperture just springing himself out of trouble there. Oh, good pin from Frog.
I had
very
the feeling
nicely
that
done.
For the Hydra Smash, but doesn't get
you know,
it.
It's that old tried and true for Aperture. And more often than not, it does work out for him. Down throw?
Up throw won't quite KO, yeah.
Oh, almost there. Alright, Aperture just hanging back, not putting too much pressure on himself to push hard. And again, we've seen his movement so clean today.
I don't disagree with that.
Oh, very nicely done. Again, seeing that he's not got the punish and willing to take a step back and collect himself.
A single hit hasn't been landed. Okay, there it is.
Oh, got the upper.
The moment a hit gets
That's
landed,
difficult for Frog because he's been doing a great job of chipping away and bringing it back. Oh, very nice movement there from Frog, actually. Just finding the Dragon Fang shot, wave bouncing.
He has still managed to get a lot of damage on Africa, so he does have a chance to...
Absolutely,
you know,
he is. There you go. I was about to say, he's just a pin away, you know? He's just a tipper away. And
like
we are back almost to neutral. 35%, that's a combo, you know?
Definitely, it's not out of this yet by any stretch.
And there we go. We are dead even. Oh, very nice there from Frog. Taking his time. Not punishing Aperture's down air onto the stage, though.
Sonic's down air, I feel like... Again, it's another one of those sort of moves that don't... Even though it's a dive move, it doesn't have as much end lag as you might expect.
And it does auto-cancel if you start it high enough. So,
right.
Oh, and this time he knows he does have the punish and goes straight for it.
Sonic. Fastest character in the game is what I'd expect, so definitely well suited to punishing that sort of thing.
Oh, nicely done there. And again, just using the top platform. There's the Hypno Smash. Using the top platform to... Oh, great! Two frame with the Hypno Smash. And Apogee's in a good position.
Oh.
Oh, very nicely done from Frog, though. Yeah. All right, down throw, back into that offstage situation. Oh, Frog using the wings that time. Taking advantage of the very thin battlefield floor. And Frog now taking his step back, looking at the... There's a back throw, but not enough to do it just yet. Apogee taking his time. He knows that. Oh, not quite enough to kill.
Right now, just doing his shot thing.
Oh, that was a good wait, but well done from Frog to just fade away. Not overcommit.
Yeah,
and not fall prey to the Hypno Smash. Up throw? Oh, forward throw. Alright, and interestingly, Frog's found it pretty comfortable to recover so far.
I feel like
Corrin's recovery is not amazing.
One more grab should do the trick from Rapture.
Oh, very nicely done. Using the spring to keep Frog from punishing. Oh. And he finds the up air that time. Again.
Mid dash drop there.
You know, and what I have noticed thus far is Frog is living a long time.
Yeah, actually.
You know, that was 160. The time before was 140 odd. But he's finding his KOs at 100.
So.
Oh, shield has gone small there. And Frog seeing the opportunity for some aggression. Oh, up air! That was unfortunate.
Trying to go for air dodge read, but Frog calmly going to straight for the up air.
Again, showing off some of that matchup knowledge. But getting caught on the... Oh, goodness me.
It's like you said. It feels like Apogee has to get a lot more damage, work a lot harder to kind of secure these KOs. Whereas Frog, you know, as you said, 100%, yeah, he's fine.
Alright, there's a punish. No!
Sonic's feet just a little bit too short.
Oh, and Frog keeping him in the air now. Ooh!
Yeah, this is a good juggle. Exactly.
Oh, very nice spin shot to get out of the situation, though. Again, we're seeing that Nair come into such strong positioning for him. Oh, I thought we were going to see another up air there.
That could have been it as well. He's on that red percentage now.
All right, but he's done a great job of bringing this back. And I thought we were going to see a pin.
Trying to bait out an air dodge, it looks like. And just go for that forward smash. Oh, no. Oh, no, Frog.
Oh, great. Great spring. Great spring. As I said, Corrin's recovery is just a little bit weak. And
it does have that vulnerability phrase though, but it doesn't.
And what Apogee did there was bonked Corrin right on the head.
Right on the head, right where it doesn't have any hitbox, doesn't have anything.
Absolutely, really between the wings is where you can interrupt it.
That's where you kind of want to put these like kind of long-lasting hitbox. At least I made a video about it. You know?
Frog won't be feeling too discouraged though. I won't. I don't think.
It is 1-1. It was a close set still. I imagine he'll be fine.
Yeah, I don't think he'll be too unhappy. You know, he brought that all the way back, and with his counter pick now, he'll be feeling confident.
He's still got a bit of fight left in him. I don't think we can count.
A lot of conversation between Frog and Apogee now.
Can't count him out just yet.
Now, where do you think we're gonna go? We're going back to Battlefield.
Battlefield.
Yeah, that's a fair choice, I guess. You know, lots of room for Apogee to run around, but Frog did take nice advantage of those platforms in the end.
It's one of those kind of rarish situations where you have a stage which is placed to actually both characters' advantage and both players are actually okay.
Oh, very nice from Apogee there, just running in and getting the upper. Oh, nicely done from Frog though.
18%.
Oh, 62%. Apogee's made a very strong start. Oh, again finding that upper. But missing the tech, and Frog now finding some damage. One of the very interesting things we've seen from Frog so far is that he'll pop up to like halfway between the platform and the actual top of the platform.
Yeah.
And throughout a Dragon Fang shot, it's so difficult to punish because of the size of the hitbox that the Dragon Fang shot puts out.
Right.
Nice movement from Frog there.
Gonna have to crouch under it, if anything.
we go. And he's bringing it all the way back again. We're seeing Aperture put on a lot of damage early, but struggled to find the kill.
I mean, I'm not terribly surprised. I'm sure Aperture can get the damage flowing once again very shortly. He's kind of looking for...
Oh, there we go.
Zappy.
Nicely done. Is that... That was very close to falling all the way down, though.
Like I was about to say, he is beginning to start looking at that KO, though, so I don't think he's particularly worried. Now, Frog having to deal with a Sonic only at 79%. Although, you know, the pin, the forward smash are both very strong moves. I'm going to kill quite this early. So Frog is...
We have seen so far that he's consistently killing at, like, 95 to 100.
True.
So all he needs is another 20% without taking too much damage, which does seem
he's
to be the key problem at the moment.
42%. It looks like it's only going to climb higher.
Nice spring there to get himself out of a punish situation. And punishing the slightly misspaced pin with big damage. This time it does seem like the platforms are coming more into play with Aperture than they are with Frog. And every time he does something like that, I get a bit worried, you know?
Well, you get used to it, I think. But I suppose, especially after what happened last game, or the first game rather, then...
Absolutely, it's just
then I'm not surprised.
So intense as well. Oh, pin!
He's gonna...
Oh, he just fed!
Oh,
he tried to kill him with the recovery, which was a great plan, actually. Oh, nice back air there to just get himself out of some damage. And good up smash as well.
Yeah, I don't agree with...
Oh, there's the pin! Again, just hitting the very toes of Sonic and taking a stock. Aperture didn't pull the trigger.
Understandable. So he does seem a bit shook after that first
game. After what happened in game one, I feel like, you know, on a fresh stock, he didn't feel comfortable going
That's
for it.
That's understandable. It's understandable.
You know, nice to see he's still got that option on deck. Frog will be feeling a bit nervous now going, oh, we can still do that.
Yeah.
Well, Aperture can just take his time, try and find this KO. He's not taking too much damage so far. Though Frog did punish a poor Hypno Smash. Alright, very intense.
And I honestly wonder if that was something like, you know, after first game, something Ixus said to me, something said to him, maybe if you're not confident in it, don't go for it or something.
Oh, there you go, covering the roll with the back kick. And Frog's brought it all the way back again. Seems like the story of this set so far is Aperture taking the lead, and then Frog coming in with some great defensive play. To bring things back to even.
I was about to say, I wouldn't count, you know, Aperture even just yet, but actually, while you were talking, he's been brought around to 99%, so definitely both at kill percentage right now.
Oh.
And Aperture's
the
single jab
fish.
Catching that forward smash. It's okay to fish for, just fish a little bit. Casual bit of fishing every now and then. That back air, not going to do it, but it does put him in a very awful position.
If at first you don't succeed,
up throw.
No,
he really
enough.
Wanted to KO, but only 155. Even with all that rage, it's still not going to do it. Oh!
And that will kill, and now Frog's in the lead.
There it is, the pin.
Back air, though, evening the stakes.
And as I said, this is going to be a very close game. Both players, last stock, 1-1, losers round. This is as intense as it gets.
There we go.
Nice string from Frog. Yeah, nice little 45% down. It's going to be helpful. Definitely want to be in the lead against Sonic. Well, you want to be in the lead against any character, but particularly when it comes to Sonic.
And this is really the first time since game one that Frog's been in the lead in terms of percent. He's been playing from behind all set. Mm. And so now that he's got a bit of breathing room, he really does seem to be settling nicely.
Although, just like that. I mean, that's the reason why, you know, Sonic usually is just ahead. His damage output is, you know, very good. But his kill culture is just a little bit lackluster. Go for it. The forward smash. Frog putting on so much pressure right now. Just.
Oh, goodness.
Trying to get something close to the edge forward smash at ledge.
Pulled the trigger just a half a moment before that. That could have been it. Great jump from Aperture to get out of the trouble. And is that. Ooh.
Aperture.
Looking for a little bit of an early stock there.
Definitely seems worried.
But we're back to neutral. Oh, good job, good job.
The pin is just so scary as a combo breaker. It's going to make it back.
A And in fact, that might be why we've seen Aperture so consistently down air to up B to get back to the ledge. That
try
pin is...
not deal with the pin, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, crap. This is so intense. I mean, he knows he doesn't have a... There we
this
go.
This is going to be it.
Frog.
This is going to be a big punish. Down throw. Going to try to look for it. Go forward smash. I was expecting the spring, but that works as well. There we go. Once again, 170%. Both players. The crowd is building up.
Absolutely even. And oh, Frog pushes
back
too hard.
Not going to do it just yet. He has one more chance. He definitely doesn't get out of it. Back out.
Oh, he missed it.
He's going to get up the ledge. There's the upper.
Oh. After
just fishing
lead,
around. He definitely
Frog
was
just a pin away from the set.
Ooh. Wise decision to just, you know, get out of that situation. Pin didn't work that time. He's going to have another chance. The
upper.
No. Good DI. Just getting out of that combo. Expecting a roll behind.
Goodness me.
This is so close. They know that! They know exactly what's going to happen. The next person to land a hit will take the set.
Goodness.
And that person is GOAT. Frog.
Frog did the job.
Animals that play Corrin.